We fight. Have you come to protest the mission as well? The news has spread to every village. It's on every tongue. We are so close. St. Odwig's cannot resist much longer. And once it relents, all others will follow in its wake. The tome will be ours. Father Dinwell is denying that women can be ordained as members of the Order of Mitharu, despite scripture to the contrary. I know that they've got the proof in their reliquary, an ancient ordination tome, but they've never let me close enough to get a glance. All are welcome into Mitharu's embrace. Ha! The hypocrites! Don't commit any crimes on my account. Of course, if Mitharu compels you to see justice done, then I won't stand in your way. The Brothers of St. Odwig's perpetual mission keep the valuable tome in their reliquary, but no one outside the Order is allowed a glimpse.
Thank you.
You must fight with me, friend. My cause is just.
Welcome. I don't remember the last time I slept. The Red Legion has everyone on guard. We don't take our eyes off the forest.
Don't tell anyone, but I once caught Ricker Egest embracing one of the monks from the mission. Quite scandalous.
It's busy today.
Come in, rest your boots by the fire, and drown your worries in a flagon of our finest. I am Arnik Arduna, and this is the famous Gorehart Inn. Stick around.
You picked the wrong...
Pull up a stool, stranger. We don't have much, but what we have won't leave a hole in your pocket. Are you here about that fey girl they found outside? I feel terrible about what happened to that girl. Gorehart used to be a nice little village. These days we're jumping at shadows. Nice
Greetings.
Talking to you.
I am Catrin. Do you require my healing touch in mind, body, or both? Be safe.
It's reassuring to have the war sworn so close. Shieldren Keep is just down the road to the east. Nice to see you.
Welcome to Gorehart, the last settlement before the Feylands. How can I fill your pack today? come see me again.
Greetings.
Oh, I didn't see you come in. I was reading this letter, and is there anything I... can I... I never thought it would happen. Coming. Even with everything else going on in this village, the Red Legion is coming for me. I was not always the pious man you see before you. No, I was a scoundrel, a raider in the dreaded Red Legion. A gang of the notorious bandit, Red the Dead Idward. But plunder could not sustain me. I wanted something more. Several of us faked our deaths and deserted, always knowing that Red might track us down. And now, he has. It's all here in Red's letter. He demands we satisfy the blood rite. 2 lives for 1. He'll let me go, but only if I kill the men who deserted with me, but I cannot. I do what I must. I only hope Ugnar and Itrin will forgive me. Ugnar works in Gorhart village. Itrin haunts the ruins near Haxi, still struggling with his demons. Be on your guard. I fear they will likely come for me as well. When it's finished, take their daggers and bring them to Red Edward. He will demand proof. Take mine to start. Good luck, my friend. May Metharu bless you. Ugnar works for the inn at Gorehart. Itrin has taken to calling himself the Shade and robs travelers in Haxi. Metharu is with you.
Please, make yourself at home. Mitharu's blessings are meant for all who are friends of the church.
Mitharu, you found the ordination tome. I'd give a sack of gold to see the look on Father Dinwell's face. He will no longer be able to deny my entrance to the order. Mitharu does embrace all. Thank you. I won't need any gold as a servant of Mitharu. Take what I have. It's yours. I will remember you in my prayers. If such creatures were not part of the Authority's plan, then they would not exist in nature, period. Mitharu's divine order governs all, even the Fae.
Need something?
Make it quick. I've got work to do. Can't pay my debts with firewood, not in Gorehart. I knew it was only a matter of time, and I'm not surprised. Delph will do anything to save his own hide, but hiring a sword to do his bloody work is disgraceful. If you want to collect my dagger, you'll have to fight me for it. Steel for steel. I used to be quite the scrapper. Didn't Delph tell you that? Right. I've spent years trying to bury my past, hoping to wash away my sins with an honest day's work. If I took the blood right, Red would owe me once more. Take my dagger. Tell him I'm dead. For the Ugnar Oddgrey you once knew is truly gone. This is folly, you know that. Hello?
Hello there. I wish I was fighting in the war. The action is in the east. No one's ever seen Tuatha this far west.
I'm not accustomed to all of this excitement. It was difficult enough to adjust life during wartime. Now we have to be on our guard for Tuatha right here in our own home. What is this world coming to? Farewell.
Welcome to Gorehart.
Ah!
Two legs, please help me. Other two legs are cruel. They will not help. No! I am cursed. You believe me. Many think I am just another two legs. They are wrong. I am a wolf, cursed to wear this shape by evil sprites as some cruel game. I still have wolf thoughts in my head, but two-leg bodies are so clumsy, they can't even catch dumb meat birds. I must be changed back. The sprites are near. Even now I smell them, but I cannot fight in this form. Will you help, Two Legs? Thank you, Two Legs. But the task will not be easy. I need water from a magic well, guarded by the sprites that cursed me. Be warned, the sprites have much magic, for the well they guard is older than this wood, and from that they draw their power. The sprites guard the well, which is near the river to the north. Beware them. They have much magic. Hunt well.
For a while, I thought only the Warsworn used the Yolven Road. Penry Kell's my name. Traveller by vocation. I have no trade, but I do have a job for one like yourself. Interested? Most travellers have qualms about dealing with the fair folk. Harder to read than a human, and fewer many pockets to pick. These ballads, Fae, they are not only rich in lore. I've heard snippets of a ballad, and a beautiful ruby ring, and I need someone to help me get it. The ballad is called Ring and Reprisal. I know little about it, but if we reenact the ballad step by step, the ring should come to us. In the story, a maiden asks a champion to reclaim a ring stolen by a troll. It's a few years too late, but I'll play the role of the maiden. You be the champion. First, you must prove your prowess by hunting wild antelope and bring back something to lure the troll. Who knows? You'd have better luck getting an answer from one of these damn fae. But it's what the ballad calls for. You can find an antelope nearby. Bring them down and get proof of your kills. We'll need them later on. May your kills be clean.
Interesting. You're not at all what I expected to find here. Oh, is that the name of this Fate Weaver? No, the Tuatha I was following killed him. I was hoping his corpse would give me an idea of why they were here. Now I know. They were hoping to find you. Knowing you, you're definitely involved. But something tells me I know you better than you knew yourself. Don't you remember me? I'm hurt. No time for introductions now. The Tuatha are still on the move. I'm certain that we'll see one another again. Soon. Be on your way.
Arden's dead. How did this happen? Why would they have come here? Why kill a harmless old Fate Weaver? They couldn't know that you were headed here. I mean, the stingy bastard owes me a week of drinks. Doesn't mean he deserved to be murdered. I was hoping to avoid this, but I think I'm going to have to take you to Delok. It's a sacred place to we Fate Weavers. Somewhere that I was hoping to avoid. I was hoping Arden could take you, but I guess it comes down to me. No reason getting anyone else killed over it. Go, I'll meet you there. Once I give Arden a proper funeral. This is twice now I've buried the bodies left in your wake.
Ah! Give me Delph's dagger, and you may find mercy in Enidon. True, but I know him, and he will not rest until one of us is satisfied the blood rite. Two must die, so one will live. I intend to be the one to live. has its uses. If Red Edward believes me dead, then I am truly free. Take the dagger. I pray it brings you better fortune than it brought me. Good luck with Red.
What, stranger? There's plenty to drink, but, ugh, the soup's wretched.
Seen the job board? Don't need to be war-sworn to take on those.
Here to join, then? Don't look like a patron.
Thank you.
I knew neither of them would face me himself. Who sent you? Was it Delph? Agna? So, you're here on behalf of Delph, that traitorous sow. I gather you're here to send a message as well. Let me guess, blood has been paid for his crimes. What Delph doesn't realize is that the blood right is a privilege of the Red Legion, and he lost that privilege when he betrayed us. The choice is yours, stranger. Throw your lot in with a monk and his coward god, or work for me. At least I will pay you for your trouble. Unwise. Some of us are richer than kings. If you're not with us, you're against us. The Red Legion drinks the blood of its enemies.
Okay.
Stay indoors after sundown.
It's done? I don't know how I feel. It's like the end of a long nightmare. How can I ever thank you? I took up a collection around the mission. I lied and said it was for charity, but you understand. The others can never know. Thank you. See you soon.
I wish I was fighting in the war. The action is in the east. No one's ever seen Tuatha this far west.
Well, care to part with some gold?
Goodbye.
I wish I was fighting in the war. The action is in the east. No one's ever seen Tuatha this far west.
What is it? Are you here for a weapon? Going to earn a lord's favor in this ridiculous war, are you? I'll be here.
Any word? Two legs?
Oh.
Two legs, do you come to me empty-handed? What is the meaning of this? The well holds powerful magic, as old as these trees. Our elders told us its true name. Your two-leg kind might call it the well that wanders. Throughout the forest, it would vanish and reappear, like a wolf on hunt. But what prey it seeks? Before I was cursed, I remember strongly atop the water was the scent of leechwood. Perhaps the well seeks that. Leechwood? That is the two-leg name for that wood that feasts on strength. It appears through the forest. Should not be hard to find. The scent of the well was strong with its odor. It must be what the well is seeking. Return swiftly.
Hello there. Hey, Mitharu, what is it you...
Oh, hello. Did Thaddeus send you? Kester Barclay, my apologies. I don't mean to be rude. This crisis has me a bit on edge. Blood plague, and the boggarts that are spreading all over Glendara. Normally, the things keep to themselves. Looks like some Jotun got into their lair, though. Force the boggarts out. You're either brave or a fool. But if you could kill the Jotun, perhaps the boggarts would leave us alone. All right. Travel north to the boggarts' lair in Coilsbane and clear out their cave. Driving the Jotun from Coilsbane would be the best thing you could do for us. Of course, Astrid Frisk could probably use some help as well. Please, hurry.
What do you mean?
I'm sorry, but I'm simply out of Plague Shield. There's nothing I can do for you or anyone else till I have it. Blasted blood plague. It treats the blood plague, which almost all of Dydenhill's sick with just now. Brother Fallon should have come with more. Can't think where he is. Good, because the whole village needs that plague shield. Never mind what happened to that old oaf. I need the medicine. 3 parcels at least. Go up the road through Glendora Wood that leads to the mission. Bring the plague shield yourself if you must. Well, Brother Fallon should have it, but then he should have been here by now. Go up into Glendora Wood toward the mission, see what you can find. Well, on your way with you.
Half the village.
My father's got the cough. He's taken to bed.
This is the 3 lamps. Plague's put my own grey in the healer's care, but we're open nonetheless.
Right then.
These damn boggarts.
Brother Father Fallon should have come. Astrid needs that medicine. Stranger?
It is there, Two Legs. The scent of water. Faint, but it does not escape me. My pack shall hear of your compassion and honor. I now go to the wilds and rejoin my pack. And now you may continue on your path, but with the knowledge of how to fight with the strength of a wolf. Now I shall drink deep of this potion and return to my kind.
and for honor, valiant warrior, destroyer of Infamnir, Duke of the Hylarans, protector of the Ring of Kyozai, discoverer of the island of Meropis, were he only to meet a better end.
Only one head, by the mercy of the gods. I thought my time had come at last. Fate does not seem to hold much stock in my expedition, but it leaves me alive to see its utter failure through to the end. I was leading an expedition to recover a pair of Arathi artifacts, known only as Shine and Shadow. I've spent the last decade researching them. Texts say the artifacts are powerful, but what they can do is never explicitly stated. Regardless, the Templars feel it best to place such items under their guard. But the Etin have hit us hard. And it's said that the artifacts are guarded in Dalak by an ancient, powerful shaman of their kind. I'm at a loss for what to do. I have not had such good news in some time. My research indicates that the artifacts are somewhere in Dalak. It seems they're now a trophy of the Etin. I can promise you this much. Though my expedition was underprepared, it was not underfinanced. A large reward waits for one who finds the artifacts. My research has tracked them to Dalak. There is talk of an ancient guardian. From the looks of this place, that's likely some Etin.
There ain't no fish today, stranger. It's best you look elsewhere. Ugh, can't even look a fish in the face anymore. Not ever since I met that nymph. I can remember when I first saw her on the cliff to the south, overlooking Etinmere. I saw that watery maiden and I fell in love with her. I've outlived my Imelda. My nephew Thaddeus up and left for Dyden Hill for want of never seeing me again. I had a chance of ending loneliness, but it was taken from me. Beasts of the wild scared her off. We were to wed by my pier, but I ain't seen her for days now. I'd search, but the monsters all ripped me to shreds. I bet you could indeed. But that's only half of what's needed. You must also find my bride-to-be. Then the wedding will be upon us. I've got to find the ring. I need to find my bear mask. I need to prepare. You best start by the pier. If she's not there, keep heading south. She's bound to be somewhere. Go on now. I will ready myself for the wedding and then catch up to you. I was to meet her at the old pier. But the gentle creature got scared by the monsters, no doubt. I first laid eyes on her from the cliff overlooking the lake, to the south. I bet if you head south, you'll still find her. Please, find my nymph!
Brief his term among our court. Virile in his living. He is fervent.
Welcome to the ruins of Delok. Yes, it doesn't look like much, but in these ruins lies the Theater of Fate, the ancient home of the Fate Weavers. Come with me. No telling what we'll find down there. It's the ruins of the Theater of Fate. This is where the first Fate Weavers learned how to read the weave. They left their wisdom behind in the Destiny Stone. I'm hoping that the stone will tell me who you are. In we go. Ever since this place was abandoned, strange beasts have moved in. Stay close. Think it's just a legend. Thank you.
The theater can show us the whole tapestry of fate laid bare. We can do nothing to change it or prevent its horror. Well, most of it. It's good to see some action again. If only one last time. Are and safe here. Thank you. I've seen this. This moment. I'm sorry, my friend. This is as far as I can take you. Supposed to... Do you have any idea what you've done? What sort of power you're playing with? You absorbed everything he was, everything he would do. You changed the weave of destiny itself. Because of you, there are deeds he won't do, children of his that won't be born. Victims that won't die when they were supposed to. Right now? No, you probably saved both our lives. But there's no way to tell what larger changes you've made in the fate of everyone around you. You are much more dangerous than I thought. We need to get you to the Theater of Fate right away. Thought I'd see it. We Fate Weavers never fully understood the power of this place. Seems there's a lot we don't understand. Gods, I should have brought another bottle. Surprise that Niskaru found its way to this place of power. Everything about these ruins is dedicated to this room, and at the center of it all is the Destiny Stone. With it, the Fae taught the Fate Weavers the answers to the deepest mysteries of fate. Put your hands on the stone, and maybe we can find answers to your own mysteries. Just put your hand on the Destiny Stone. It'll show me where you fit into the tapestry of fate. The Destiny Stone came apart at your touch, and all around you, the tapestry of fate, unweaving itself. And there at the core was the Codex of Destiny, the wisdom that the Fae used to help the first Fate Weavers understand the nature of the weave. Don't you see what this means? Small price to pay for the Codex of Destiny. If we can find a way to read that, it might help us understand something about you. But for now, just understand this. You're changing the fate of everyone you meet. That could make you more powerful than anything that's walked this world. As dangerous as an open flame, you could help people or destroy them entirely. When you get involved, there's no grand cosmic plan, only freedom and all the dangers that come with it. And that means I owe you Wait, what's that?
Purge the abomination! In the name of Gathlaw!
You're not working with the Tawatha.
I don't care if you trust me. I'm much more interested in your friend here. I'm beginning to think that these Tawatha don't like you. Now, why do you think that might be? After all, someone who can change the fate of the world, who wouldn't want you? I'm not sure, but they're very well informed about your location. They came straight here from Didenhill. But they're not nearly as interesting as you, especially now that they're dead. Now it's my turn. Why are you here? Ha! Knowing the future is for fools. Who reads the end of a book before it's time? Save your attention for the present. Like that codex you found? Our scholars thought those were all gone from the world. But you're just full of surprises. Good luck understanding it. That's Fae knowledge. They don't even have a written language. The stone is simply embedded with what they know, unseeable to mortals. Normally, I'd suggest looking in Issa, but the Fae are not fond of unexpected guests. But don't look so sad. There's still hope. When you're ready, meet me at the House of Ballads. Be on your way.
We can't trust her. Never met a Darklefar who'd give me a straight answer, even with a sword at their throat. But she wasn't wrong about that codex. Just be careful doing anything she suggests. Meanwhile, we can't just ignore the Tuatha that are tracking you. We need to do something about them. She said they came through Dydenhill, didn't she? They don't belong in these lands, so they probably left a trail wide as an Eden's backside. Meet me there, and we'll track them down. Maybe we can find out why they're after you, or at least how they can find you so easily. I've got some final rites to perform before I leave this place. Good luck.